Hello friends, we are discussing about divide and conquer chapter. Okay, in that next divide and conquer example is merge sort. This is one of the sorting techniques. Merge sort is a perfect example of a successful application of the divide and conquer technique. It sorts a given array A of 0 to n minus 1 by dividing it into two halves, A of 0 to n by 2 minus 1 and A of n by 2 to n minus 1. Okay, so it sorts a given array. Okay, it contains some array elements in array. Okay, you have to divide it into two halves. Okay, so first half, then second half. Then the first half is A of 0 starting from A of 0 to n by 2 minus 1. Okay, n by 2 is the half, you start from 0, that's why you have to take 1 less, so n by 2 minus 1. Then second half start from n by 2, okay, start from n by 2, A of n by 2 to last element, last position n minus 1. You start from 0, that's why last element is n minus 1. Sorting each of them recursively and then merging the two smaller sorted arrays into a single sorted one. Okay, you have to sort using recursive. Okay, and you have to merge the two smaller sorted arrays. First you have to divide, go on split, then you have to go on combine. Okay, just go on merge the smaller sorted arrays. Okay, let's see the algorithm. Merge sort A of 0 to n minus 1, that array elements contain what? And position from 0 to n minus 1. Sorts array A of 0 to n minus 1 by recursive merge sort. By using recursive merge sort technique, we have to sort the array elements, that is A of 0 to n minus 1. Input: an array A of 0 to n minus 1 of alterable elements. Okay, what is the input? You have to input the array elements. What is the output? Array A of 0 to n minus 1 sorted in non-decreasing order. Okay, the output is what? In ascending order or non-decreasing order. The algorithm is, if n is greater than 1, okay, if there is one element, nothing to sort, that itself in sorted meaning. Okay, if there is only one element, okay, if contain more than one element, then you have to apply this algorithm. Copy A of 0 to n by 2. Okay, copy A of 0 to n by 2 minus 1 means first half to B. Okay, first assign first half of the array, okay, to array B, that is from 0 to n by 2 minus 1. Then copy A of n by 2 second half. Okay, array contain what? You have to make half of first half store in array B, second half store in array C. Okay, second half start from A of n by 2, last A of n minus 1. Then you have to assign it in array C. Okay, starting from 0 to n by 2 minus 1 means second half array, the first element is A of n by 2. Okay, that you have to assign in C of 0, like this. Okay, then second element from second half A of n by 2 plus 1, you have to assign in C of 1, like this. Okay, so B of 0 to n by 2 minus 1 contain what? First half of the array. C of 0 to n by 2 minus 1 contain what? Second half of the array. Merge sort B of 0 to n by 2 minus 1. Okay, so again you call recursively. Okay, merge sort, again you divide. Okay, so first half, then in that first half again you make half. Okay, like this you go on make up till you get single elements. Okay, when you take example, you come to know. So then after doing all splitting all the array elements, then you have to merge it. Okay, merge B comma B means first half array, C second half array, A means what? That is a sorted array. Okay, there is a separate algorithm for merge. Okay, this is what merge algorithm. Okay, before that I will just explain one example. Okay, so this is one array. Okay, you have to split. Okay, so So here there are 8 elements are there. First 4, one side, 8, 3, 2, 9. Okay, 8, 3, 2, 9, first up here. 7, 1, 5, 4 here. Okay. Then again, these 4 elements again split into 2, 2 elements. Okay. 8, 3, 2, 9. Okay. Then here also, 7, 1, 5, 4. Then again, 8 separate, 3 separate. 2 separate, 9 separate. 7 separate, 1 separate. 5 separate, 4 separate. Till here you have to split. Okay. So till here what I explained in above example, above algorithm. Okay. So till here it is completed. Okay. What? That splitting it. Okay. Then you have to sort. Okay. You have to sort and merge. Okay. So here 8 and 3. So which is the smaller one? 3 is the smaller one. First you have to write 3. Then write 8. Then 2 and 9. Okay, which is smaller one? 2 first you have to write, 9 second. Then 7 and 1. Sorry. So 7 here, 1 here. Okay. 7 here, 1 here. So 1 first, then 7 next. 5, 4. Then 4 come first, 5 later. Okay. So after joining 2, 2, this is in order. Okay. This is in order. Okay. Next you have to take, next you have to combine what? Next you have to merge these two array elements. Okay. So here 3, 8. 2, 9 is there. How to combine? First 2, which is the smaller one, 2 is the smaller one. 2 you have to write first. Then 3, then 8, then 9. So this is in order. Then here 1, then you have to write 4, then 5, then 7. Okay. Now you have to combine both. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this 7, then 8, then 9. Okay. Now this is in the ascending order. Okay. So this is just example. Okay. Now we'll see how to merge it. This is very important. Okay. So here how to merge it. Example here, this is one array elements and this is array element. How to merge it? Okay. In increasing order. Okay. So merge B of 0 to P minus 1. Okay. So first half is array B. Then second half is array C. Okay. Consider this example. This is first half, this is second half. Okay, this is array B, this is array C. Okay. Okay. So B of 0 to P minus 1, that is first half. C of 0 to Q minus 1, that is second half. Okay. So here P means what? The last position of the array B. Q means what? Q minus 1 is the last position of the array C. Then array A. A 0 to P plus Q minus 1. If you combine both, okay, both, yeah, after sorting all the array elements of B and C, okay, after sorting you have to assign in array B. Merges two sorted arrays into one sorted array. Okay, we are merging what? We are merging two sorted array. This is one half sorted array. This is half sorted array. You have to merge and assign in array B, array A. Inputs array B 0 to P minus 1. This is first half and C 0 to Q minus 1. Okay, this is second half and these are all sorted one. So in this example, how these are sorted here. Okay. Okay, then output. Output is what? Sorted array A started. Okay, you have to assign in A. Okay, the sorted final all array element assign in A. Starting from 0 to P, okay, that is array first, then a total, so 0 to P plus Q minus means what? Combination of array B and array C, combination of array A, array B and array C, okay, that is total is how much? 0 to P plus Q minus 1, okay, so of the elements of B and C, okay, so this is what final result, okay, that sorted array elements in array A. 0 to P plus Q minus 1. Okay. Then initially, I equal to 0, J equal to 0 and K equal to 0. Okay. While you have to repeat the loop, while I less than P. Okay. P means what? The last position of the array B. And J less than Q. Q is what? The last position of the array C. Okay. This is first half, this is second half. Initially I and J and K, all three are 0. Okay. Next, if, okay, array if b of I less than or equal to c of j. Okay, so here b of I is the first term. Okay, initially I equal to 0, b of 0 means what? The first element of the array b. C of j also 0. C means what? The second half sorted array element, second half. Okay, so here, now we have to combine both the arrays, array b and array c, in order. So b is in half sorted order, c is in half sorted order. That half do these two half of sorted arrays are there, you have to make it in one sorted full array. Okay, so for that, so you have to check whether array b first element is smaller or array c array elements are smaller. Which is smaller, that one you have to place in array a. Okay, so if b of i is less than c of j, okay, if first array b, that first element is smaller, then that element you have to assign in a of k, means k also 0, means a of 0. If for example here, so in this example if you take, so here 2 and 1, okay, so this is array b and this is array c, okay, this is array a. So first element 2 and 1, is 2 is less than 1? No. Okay, if it is 1, then that if it is smaller, then that smaller you have to place here. So in this example here 1 is smaller, so 1 you have to place first. Okay, so b of I less than c of j, in that example 2 is less than 1. Okay, it is false. Okay, so else part, a of k is equal to c of j, you assign array c element, that is 1, element 1, assign in a of 0. Okay, so in this example, okay, so here 2 is less than 1 become false. So else part, so you assign the c array element, that is c of j, in a of k. Okay, this is position k, this is I, this is j position, this is k position. You assign the c of j in a of k. C of j you assign in a of k. Okay, k also 0, j also 0. The first element of the array c you assign in first element array a. Okay, so then what you have to do is j you have to increment, means j means what? The next position you are assigned one here, you assigned one here. Okay, next what you have to compare, you have to compare 2 and 4. Okay, one is placed here. Okay, next what you have to assign 2 and 4. Okay, in 2 and 4 what happens, 2 is smaller, so 2 placed here. Okay, like this. So after assigning first element, you have to increment j and also k. Okay, so this loop repeats, okay, again and again. Okay, this loop repeats again and again. Okay, so next element is what? So here k incremented and j incremented. So but I is not incremented in this example. In this example, I is not incremented because I is in I is 0 only. So now you have to compare 0, I is 0, then j is 1. Okay, you have to compare 2 and 4. Okay, yes, 2 is less than 4, then you have to place 2. Okay, then you have to increment I. So I comes here, then k also increment. Okay, so here b of I less than c of j. Okay, I is 0, c is 1. Okay, b of 0 is what? 2 here, in this example 2. Okay, in this example b of I is what? 2. Okay, then c of j is 1, c of 1 is what? 4. C of 1 is 4. Okay, so 2 less than 4, so what happens? Yes, condition matches. Then a of k means a of 1 equal to b of 0 is what? 2. 2 is assigned in a of 1. Okay, so a of 1 contains what? 2 here. Clear, no? Okay, so like this it repeats. Next what happens, so then again k also incremented. Okay, so k increment both time. Okay, if b of I less than c of j, condition matches, then also k increment. If else part, okay, when you here assign a c value, array element c in k, then also k increment. Okay, so if b of I less than c of j, I only increment, j not increment. If else part, b of I less than c of j, condition false, at that time j only increment, I not increment. Okay, but k increment in both condition. If b of I less than c of j, if it is false or true in both situation, k get increment. Okay, so either you place b array element or either you place c array element, either one definitely execute. Okay, so in both condition k anyway incremented. I when increment, I when b of I less than c of j condition satisfied, then I increment. If condition false, then j increment. Okay, so like this it repeats till either I less than p and j less than q. Okay, so here I less than p means what? The first array elements, all the first array elements, and j less than q, j less than q, okay, all the second array elements. Okay, if either one is either one is full, then it stops. Okay, means you assign all the array elements of b in a, then it stops. Or all the elements of array c you assign in a, then also it stops. Any one condition matches, okay, it stops. Okay, if any one is false, okay, because assume array b is full, okay, you assign all the array b elements in a, then it stops. Okay, then if I is equal to p, okay, means you assign all the array b elements in array a, okay, then in array c there are some elements are left. Okay, so then what happens? Copy the remaining elements. Okay, copy the remaining elements of c in a. Okay, or sometime all the array elements of c you assigned in a, but some elements are left of array b. Okay, then if all the elements of array c is assigned in array a, then some elements are left in array b, then it assigns what? All the remaining b elements to in assign in array a. Okay, so this is about the algorithm. I take one more example, it become very clear to you. Okay, so this is one example. Assume this is first half array. Okay, this is second half array, means array b, array c, then this is array a. Okay, so this is array b, assume this is first half sub array, this is the second array. Okay, so initially I equal to 0, j equal to 0, k equal to 0. Okay, so here first it check, 1 is less than 6, yes, assign 1 in k. Okay, here it assign k here. Okay, then I get incremented. If you assign 1 here, then I get incremented, I comes here, but j remains 0. Now you compare 5 and 6, which is smaller? 5 is less than 6, yes. If it is yes, so assign 5 here. Okay, assign 5 here. Okay, then you increment I value, then j remains 0. You have to increment k also, k become 2. Now you compare 10 less than 6, no, 10 is not less than 6. Okay, condition false. Then what you have to do is you have to assign 6 here. Okay, so you have to assign 6 in position k equal to 2. Okay, in k equal to, you have to assign 6 here. Previously it was 10, now it replaced with 6 here. Okay, then you have to increment j value, k value remains same. Okay, then after that compare 10 and 9. Okay, 10 is less than 9, no, then if it is no, assign 9 in k equal to 3 position. Okay, assign 9 here. Okay, so what happens here? You place 9 here. Okay, then there is no element to compare here, so this array is full. This all the elements of this second array you assigned in array a. Okay, then what you have to do is the remaining two elements, okay, that remaining two elements you have to place 10, you have to place here in k equal to 4, then you have to increment I value and k value, then 12 you have to place here. Okay, 10 you have to place here and 12 you have to place here. Okay, so after you assign 10 here, then you have to increment I value. Okay, I comes here, I become 3, then assign I value to I is 3 here. There is no element to compare here, because the second array is already assigned in array A. Okay, the last element you directly assign in this array, okay, array A, okay, like this. So first what you have to do is you have to initially I, j, k, j, o, okay, you have to compare first and second element, okay, which is smaller that you have to place, okay, and you have to increment I and k, okay, then compare 5 and 6 here, okay, so if condition satisfies, increment I, increment k, j remains same, okay, so then compare 10 and 6, okay, so here 6 is smaller, okay, so 6 you have to place here, okay, 6 is placed here, then you have to increment j value, but I remains same, okay, then you compare 10 and 9, okay, 10 is, and if you compare 10 and 9, 9 is smaller, so 9 you have to place here, okay, then you have to increment j become 2 here, okay, so only 2 elements are present in this array, okay, so again there are no elements to compare here, okay, there is no element to compare 10 with other this array elements, okay, so you have to stop the loop, okay, that's why that while loop, okay, j less than q or p less than I less than p and j less than q, if anyone is full, okay, if any condition satisfies, so here this condition satisfies here, j less than q condition become false, okay, because j become 2 here, there are only 2 elements, 2 less than 2 become false, okay, then the loop is stops. After the loop is stopped, what I have to do is the remaining elements, okay, so here in first array 10 and 12 is remain here, okay, so that 10 you have to place next, okay, in next position, that you have to place, no comparison, 10 you have to place here and 12 you have to place here, see 10 you have to place here in this position, 10 placed here, then 12 you have to place in this position, okay, then now it is in sorted order, okay, this is about the merge sort. Okay, so here first you check first array with the second array, if it is smaller you assign that array elements in array A, okay, then you increment I, okay, if it is false then you assign C array C in array A, then you increment J, okay, in both situations you increment K, okay, so you just go on repeats, if any one array is full then you stop the loop, okay, either j less than q, if it is false then you stop the loop, or I less than p, it is false, then also stop the loop, okay, if I equal to p, okay, means if array is all the array elements you assigned here, okay, then you transfer all the remaining elements in A, okay, if p, I equal to p means what, that array is the first array is full, okay, there is no element is remaining, then you assign array C elements in array A, remaining elements, if I is equal not equal to p is false, meaning is what, j is equal to q, means second array is full, if second array is full then the remaining elements of first array, okay, that assign into array A, like this, okay. So this is the algorithm. Okay. Next analysis. Here the basic operations is key comparison. Okay, here comparisons are more, as merge sort executes does not depend on the order of the data. Best case, average case, runtime are the same as worst case runtime. Anyway, you are comparing. Okay. Whether if it is already sorted, then also you compare. Okay, so comparisons required here, okay, so there is all are same here. Worst case, during key comparison neither of the two array becomes empty before other one contains just one element, least the worst case of the merge sort, okay, assuming for simplicity total number of elements n is power of 2, okay, total number of elements is what, n is power of 2. The recurrence relation for the number of key comparison C of n is C of n is equal to 2 C n by 2 plus c merge n for n greater than 0, c of 1 is equal to 0. Okay. So this is the recurrence relation for the key comparison. Okay. Where c merge is the number of key comparisons made during merging stage. Okay. So c merge of n is what? Number of key comparisons. How many times you compare with first array with second array? Okay. Let us analyze c merge of n, the number of key comparisons performed during the merging stage. At each step, exactly one comparison is made, after which the total number of elements in the two arrays still needing to process is reduced by one. In the worst case, neither of the two arrays becomes empty before the other one contains just one element. Okay. Example, smaller elements may come from alternating arrays. Therefore, for the worst case, c merge of n is equal to n minus 1. Okay. So, in worst case, c merge of n is equal to n minus 1. C worst of n is equal to 2 c worst of n by 2 plus n minus 1 for n greater than 1. C worst of 1 is equal to 0. If it is only one element, then there is no comparison. If it is more than 1, so this is the worst case comparison. Solving the recurrence relation equation using master theorem. Here a is equal to 2, here a is equal to 2, b is equal to 2, then f of n, okay, n the power of 1, that power of 1 is what? D is equal to 1. Therefore 2 is equal to 2 the power of 1. Okay, so 2 is equal to 2 the power of 1. Case 2 holds in the master theorem. Okay, according to case 2, c worst of n is equal to theta of n the power of d log n. Theta of d value is what? 1. Okay, log n. So finally, theta is equal to n log n. Therefore, c worst of n is equal to theta of n log n. Let's see the advantages. Number of comparisons performed is nearly optimal. Okay, the number of comparisons what is optimal. For large n, the number of comparisons made by this algorithm is the average case turns out to be about 0.25 n less, hence is also theta of n log n. Okay, for large number of comparisons made by this algorithm is average case turn out to be 0.25 n less. Okay, hence is theta n log n. Okay, so here in for large n elements, okay, in the average case, 0.25 n is less. Merge sort will never degrade to big O of n square. Okay, so in merge sort, never degrade to big O of n square. In some algorithm, take big O of n square. Okay, so but this one never degrade to big O of n square. Another advantage of merge sort over quick sort and heap sort is stability. Okay, compared to other sorting techniques. Okay, so merge sort is stability. A sorting algorithm is said to be stable if two objects with equal keys appear in the same order in sorted output as they appear in the input array to be sorted. Limitations. The principal shortcoming of merge sort is linear amount, big O of n, of extra storage the algorithms require. So here you need array B, array C, okay, you need array A, so extra memory is required here. Okay, actually array A is main array. Okay, so you need extra array B and array C. Okay, so it's an extra memory space. Though merging can be done in place, the resulting algorithm is quite complicated and of theoretically interest only. Okay, a little complicated one. Variations of merge sort. The algorithm can be implemented bottom up by merging pairs of arrays elements, then merging the sorted pairs, and so on. So here the algorithm can be implemented bottom up, okay, by merging. Okay, first you go and divide, then you take a single element, you join it, join it. Okay, then again you take two elements, make it four, then take four element, make it eight, like this you go on continuous. This avoids the time and space overhead of using a stack to handle recursive calls. Okay, so here it avoids the time and space overhead of using stack. Okay, so normally in the recursion, so whenever you function call the function, you need to assign all the elements in a stack. Then when it come back from main function, then you have to take it back. But here it is avoids the time and space overhead of using stack to handle recursive calls. We can divide a list to be sorted in more than two parts. Sort each recursively. Okay, so here you are dividing the list to be sorted in more than two parts. Okay, so in example I shown only two parts here. Okay, actually sometime divide in more than two parts also. Okay, sort each recursively, then that part, each part you have to sort recursively, and then merge them together. Then you have to merge all the parts into one. This scheme, which is particularly useful for sorting files residing on secondary memory devices, is called multi-way merge sort. Okay, this scheme helps in if there are two different files out there. Okay, if you want to merge both the two files in practically, okay, in your computer in hard disk, it contains assume the two separate files. Suppose you want to combine both the files. Okay, at that time this merge sort technique is very helpful. Okay, that is called multi-way merge sort. Okay, so this is about the merge sort. In next video, we'll study quicksort. Okay, thank you.